there is some food and wine merch.
So you have the Loungefly ears.
These are $44.99 in the park.
Also a new Loungefly.
I like that these are like embroidered on. In the back it says Food and Wine Festival 2024. And it's retailing for $58. Not too bad. It's not your usual like faux leather. It's a canvas bag. But I really like this part too, like this whole pocket. And then there's a spirit jersey. In the front, it just says Food and Wine. No price tag.
So the crowds are looking kind of busy. This is where you can purchase a Sip and Savor pass.
We purchased ours at the Five and Dime.
And actually, we're gonna go in here so you can place our order.
A bunch of the booths are over here in this corner. So Nuts About Cheese is there. And then you can just order here and then pick up locations. So we already pretty much know what we're getting. So we can't wait. We're pretty hungry. We just drove in. So we're ready to get our grub on.
All right. So we have our first item from the Food and Wine Festival. We have the barbecue pulled pork mac and cheese. Can't wait to dig in. That's our first item that we picked up. We're super excited to try it. And we'll let you know what the rating is. So let's get Food and Wine started. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and give our rating. You go first.
I gave it a 9. It was really good. And like, it was like, the pulled pork is good and the mac and cheese is good, and like the flavors, they went well together, and I like it.
I agree. I give it a 10 though. I thought the pulled pork was really tender. It's not like over salty. The barbecue sauce gives it like a nice kind of like sweet and savory taste, and I think we did a really good job picking something so good on our first item for Food and Wine Festival. So I give it a 10 out of 10. The mac and cheese is not like super dry. Like I said, the pulled pork is not like dry either. I feel like it's really tender. The flavor is great, and the crispy onions really give it a nice crunch too. So 10 out of 10. I can't wait to see what else they have today. We wanted to try the old-fashioned ice cream bar that they have, but they are out for the day. So just be aware of that if you come and you try to do Food and Wine. I guess they do sell out of some things. So it's actually pretty early too. It's only like maybe about 11, and it's actually raining pretty hard over here. It's like coming down like randomly really hard. I'm gonna show you guys, but I'm like looking around me, it's like getting pretty crazy out here. So let me show you what the weather looks
like. So if you decide to come for Food and Wine, there is a magic-y area that you can come to. You can kind of see it here, and it's like a kind of like a preferred seating area for Food and Wine. I should have went there, but I seen an open table with an umbrella, so we ran over here because it is starting to come down.
You can kind of see, so a lot of people have ponchos and umbrellas today, but you know what, I think
it's not stopping anybody from coming by because it's still pretty packed. So we're gonna go ahead and finish this off and then see what we try next.
So it actually hasn't rained like this hard. Actually, I don't think I've ever been here and it's rained this hard. We came in February, a month ago exactly. It rained, but it didn't rain like this. I mean, it's like windy and my umbrella is going crazy. Oh God. Umbrella, and then just the rain's really coming down, so we're gonna get our food and then price it somewhere, and I'm gonna check the weather to see when the rain stops, because yeah, it sure is coming down. But what people will do for Disney.
We're in Elias and Co. just trying to kill time, but there's the new Spider-Man Pandora charm.
That Star Wars Millennium Falcon charm's pretty cool. I like that Pirates one. Nothing really new necessarily that's catching my eye, I don't think.
Just
just gave me like a good idea though, because I do have that Sorcerer Mickey hat charm, and I never thought of like wearing it as a necklace, so that's pretty cool. How cute is that? Little matching shirt. Backpack is really cute. Oh, how cute! It's adorable. Even the straps are really cute. Oh, look at the back. If I can show you without my umbrella getting in the way. $88, typical Loungefly price. Also a matching wallet. I don't think this is Loungefly though. But the wallet is $50. Oh yeah, here you go. So my sister pointed out that this is the matching wallet. So cute. This is going for $50. Oh yeah, I would definitely get this one. Not only does it match, I just think it's cuter. These little Stitch Crocs are so cute for kids. Let's see, there's a price tag. No price tag. Very cute though. So here's like one of the newest collections. It's this pizza collection. I will not be purchasing this one, but let's see how much.
What a steal.
$88. It's just an all-over print. Yep, I will not be getting that one. How cute this sweater is. Has Remy, says c'est la vie. Here's what the back side looks like. I think it's pretty cute. T-shirt's pretty cute too. Has Remy and Emil. $34.90. So we have a Minnie Mouse Easter plush. She's so cute. And then of course Mickey. $34.99. They're so adorable though. There's the spirit jersey. A little bit much for me. Here's what the ears look like. I think those are actually pretty cute, but I mean, I still wouldn't buy them. These are $39.99 though. So there is this Spider-Man art kit. Pretty cool. Turn it around, what's the price on it? Price is $29.99. It's everything that it comes with. Some paint, some stencils, all your usual stuff, but pretty cool Spider-Man theme. I really like this Mickey and Friends coloring book. And it's $6.99. I just thought that was really cute. Not something you see every day. And they have a really cute Princess and the Frog art set. This is really pretty. Adult coloring kit. Typically designed for Magic Key Holders t-shirt right now. And it has all of the booths here at the Food and Wine Festival. And this shirt is retailing for $34.99. And of course, you can use your Magic Key discount. Here's another t-shirt. I'm trying to look for the price. Oh, there it is. $34. I like the other shirt better. Some new pins. These coasters. I actually like these. $24.99. Oh, I think these are so cute, these salt and pepper shakers. I feel like I want to start collecting them. I probably shouldn't, but they're so cute, I want to. And then you have a Food and Wine coffee mug, avocado time. Very cool.
nice wine glass. $14.99, not too bad.
There's also a die cut magnet.
Not bad, $40.
$14.99. Just like a little, I wouldn't say keychain, but like an ornament, kind of. Yeah, like an ornament. It is $19.99. Wow, I didn't expect that. It's more than the wine glass. And it's like very thin, just plastic. This is pretty neat. It's just like a sign. I think it's pretty cute though. It's like a tin type sign for $29. I feel like that's a little bit of a steep price for that, but I mean, it's really cute and literally you can only get that here, so not bad.
Okay, this shirt's pretty cute. I'm trying to find a price. Oh, here we go. Okay, we have a tag, no price, probably $34.99.
So here's my drink. I got a watermelon mojito cocktail. Unfortunately, they ran out of watermelon slices, so I don't have the garnish, but it's okay. And we have the Impossible Chicken Parm Bites. It has a tomato sauce, cheese, and then some more cheese on top. And then we have a pork belly, piece of pork belly with some mac salad on the side. So we're really excited to try that. I'm a little nervous about the Impossible Chicken Parm Bites, but we'll let you know how it is. My sister's drink, she got a mango lassi. Actually looks really good. It has some fresh pieces of mango on it. What do you rate it?
A 10.
Okay. And then we got the chicken lollipop with poblano mashed potatoes. So we're going to try these items, let you know how they go. Mm-hmm. We said we're going to start first with the chicken parm though, the Impossible, because this way if it's not good, then at least we have some meat to finish off with here. So this is going to be first, second, and then probably last.
All right, so we took our bites of the Impossible chicken parm. My sister gave it a 7. I give it a 10. Someone who is not vegan, I have to say that it does taste like chicken. It's not as crispy like chicken parm. I think, you know, just because it's been sitting, they make them like ready to serve. But the tomato sauce is really good. That cheese sauce on top is really nice. And it does taste like chicken. It's crazy. So I give it a 10 just for that. Okay, that corn mac salad is so delicious. It is amazing. The pork belly, really nice and tender, good flavor, but I think the star, honestly, is that corn mac salad. It's like nice and spicy, has nice texture to it. I give it a solid 10. What do you give it?
An 8,
okay. So the ratings are in. I give the chicken parm the Impossible chicken parm because it tastes like real chicken parm. So for it being impossible meat and tasting that close to it, it's a 10 in my book. The pork belly and the corn mac salad, 10. The pork belly was great. Disney really knows how to do their pork belly. The mac salad was delicious, spicy, had a lot of texture. Besides that one big piece of garlic that they almost got me with, luckily I caught it. Now the chicken lollipop with the poblano mashed potatoes, I give that one a 4. Flavor wise it's okay. Chicken is a little dry. I like how different the mashed potatoes taste, like the poblano, you can taste it, it's nice, but I don't know, I mean, I think, yeah, I would have to give this a 4. Sister, what do you think?
Impossible, I give it a 7. Okay. It tastes like McDonald's chicken nuggets, but I don't like chicken and parm.
Okay, yeah, she doesn't really count because she doesn't ever eat chicken and parm, like ever, so I don't really think she counts.
And
anyways.
That, I give it a 6.
What?
Because...
Why do you give it a 6? What do you give a 6? Okay, why?
Because.
Why so low?
Because.
Okay. Anyways.
Because.
just because. What do you give?
Because it's... it's oily.
That was oily. Yeah, it is oily. Like, you can see the oil in there for sure, but...
It's a 3.
She gives it a 3. I give it a 4. I give it a 4 because, like, the creativity of it, I guess. So that's why I give it a 4, but... Those are so far some of our offerings that we had. I think we have about 4 tabs left. I did not use a tab for this one. I paid for this separately, so it was $7.99. And I did get to use my Magic Key discount, so that's always nice. But the watermelon mojito is delicious too. I'm gonna drink that down. The rain has stopped, thankfully. And if you are interested in getting the mango lassi or the chicken in lollipop, or chicken lollipop, you can get it from the Coca-Cola refreshment truck. Studio Catering Co. Sorry, that's a technical name.
Look at how pretty that is. So they have a lot of the classic movies. So Cinderella, Snow White.
Yeah, that's kind of sour.
Donald Duck's boat. D stage. I've never heard of these. There's also Lilo and Stitch. So adorable. $1.25. I also like this Jim Shore Madame Leota. Ooh, this one too. Couture figurine for $1.10. I always like to check which ones they have on display. So they have Bambi, Snow White, Sleeping Beauty, and the Hitchhiking Ghost. There are the prices.
This is the first time we're ever going to do this, so I'm pretty excited. I am bad at drawing, so probably shouldn't be doing this, but. Sounds like fun.
Animation Academy, so keep the, those drinks sealed up and the snacks put away. Artists would do it. They'd start out with a basic shape, a circle, a square, and then build and carve out of that until they've got what they want. But with no eraser on your pencil, here you do. Class is dismissed. Have a great day, everyone.
Round of applause for Thomas.
Hey, dudes. Whoa, dude. Oh, is that my buddy Mike?
Yes, it is, Crush.
Hey, Mike, dude, you think you'd help me make contact with the human dudes?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, let's go over here.
Hey!
Hey there, Bailey, dude. What's going on?
Oh, my goodness. Funny looking humans, huh?
Dude, Bailey, hydrophone is on. They can, like, totally hear you, dude.
No, they can't. Watch this. Hi, humans.
See, dude?
Okay. Why didn't you tell me?
Well, I tried to, dude, but you're all like...
Wait.
Like that.
I'm getting something.
It was in Oakland.
Wow. Every human in the seats has a shiny rectangle that lights up. That's weird.
Yeah, dude, those are called showboats.
Later, Crush.
Bailey.
Hey, here's the new butterscotch banana poodle. It has pieces of butterscotch and banana, and I'll put a description. There's a lot going on here, but it smells delicious, just like banana, so I'm gonna go ahead and try this.
Update on the butterscotch banana toodle. I give it a 7. I like it. I like banana flavored things. It's just super sweet. I mean, toodles already are pretty sweet, but not too bad. But I feel like this is a little overly sweet. I think it may be the icing on top. But I did like the bits of banana and butterscotch on it. I'd say a solid 7 out of 10. I think it's worth a try, though. Okay, DCA.
Period.
Okay, so here are three of the last five items that we have picked up for the end of the night. So this is a cheeseburger bao bun, cheese pizza, chicken wings, and the carbonara mac and cheese. So we're gonna dig in, let you know what the ratings are. All right, so the bacon carbonara mac and cheese has a lot of flavor. It's just a little bit too garlicky for me. If you love garlic, you are going to love this. I like garlic, but I feel like it's a little bit overpowering. Out of 10 though, I would probably have to give it a 7. Flavor's there. I like the crispy panko on top. The bacon's really nice, but again, I think it's just the garlic. It does have a little bit of spice. The actual like cheese sauce and the mac and cheese is really good. But I have another bite. Here we go. So, kind of hard to tell, but there are chili flakes. So that's what's giving it the nice little kick. But I feel like it needs it. Okay, so here's a close-up on the cheeseburger bao bun. So it has Thousand Island, and it has a little bit of like a pickle relish, tomatoes, some sesame seeds for the bun, and some grilled onions. So looks good. We're gonna cut this in half though and show you what it looks like inside. I feel like it's kind of hard to tell, but look at all that ground beef in there. It really does look like those cheeseburger sliders that you can make like with the Hawaiian rolls at home. We'll see. We're gonna try it out. Why is it a 10?
Pretty good as heck.
Good as heck. You heard it for yourself. Alright. It is a 10. It's delicious. It's like sweet because the bao bun and Thousand Island really brings it together. That pickled slaw, the grilled onions, and the fresh tomato really brings it together. And the ground beef is like not overcooked. It's like perfect, honestly. That's a solid 10 out of 10. I think if you eat like two of these, you'd be super full. It's very filling. And we still have chicken wings to eat. And we still have some of this to dig into. And we have two other items after this. I'm already feeling pretty stuffed, but that is why I love the Food and Wine Festival, because you can try different things and you can share them. We usually share them like between three people, and we all get pretty full. It'll usually be like my mom and my sister and I. But when my dad comes along, we have to do two sip and savor passes because he can eat more. So I do think it's a good deal, but we're gonna try these wings next. Got some ranch dressing.
Is it like Wingstop?
I doubt it.
Let's see. I think I might go for that drop.
Is there a flat in there? All right. Oh. Good? What does it taste like?
Honestly, it tastes like the garlic parmesan from Wingstop.
Okay.
And like, it has a little bit of sweet, and it's really crunchy.
Mmm. Okay, that sounds good. I can't wait to dig in. What do you rate it though?
Like a 9.
A 9, okay.
Pretty good.
All right, looks like we have a winner. Our least favorite, we've decided, was the bacon carbonara mac and cheese. If you're a garlic lover, you'll love it, but I think you should use your tabs on the cheeseburger bao bun and the wings. Strawberry horchata. She's setting up a video to record herself trying it again.
It is so good.
Is it life-changing?
It's life-changing.
So it's 10 out of 10?
Yes, and it actually tastes like horchata. Like, it's not, like, artificial. Like, no, it's really good.
Okay. Sounds like a winner. You can get this here at Cocina Cucamonga. This thing is stupid good. You have to try this. Solid 10. Alrighty, so we have the pineapple upside down bread pudding. So, your classic pineapple upside down cake, but bread pudding. It's the perfect collab. And I got myself a peach soju Rita, or no, peach soju cocktail. Super delish. I've had that plenty of times. I love it. It's nice and refreshing, but I'm super excited to try this. It's nice and warm. Feeling really full, but I had to try it, so let's dig in. So we are just winning right now. She's loving what we've gotten. That horchata is that good. This pineapple upside down bread pudding. Stupid good too. Oh. Clearly, she doesn't like it. It's horrible.
It's really mid.
Really mid, she said. Not worth it. Not worth the $7.99. Let's talk about that price. That's an awesome price, honestly. No, we love it. Solid 10. Okay, we're inside Smoke Jumper's Grill because it is warm in here. But we have the shrimp papas locas dish here. So it looks like a big like hash brown patty. And then you have some shrimp and nopales on top and some cheese sauce on the side. And this, I've had this before, I'm pretty sure, but this is a chili relleno empanada. Looks pretty good. It has cotija cheese on top. And everything looks pretty good. These are our last two items. I'm absolutely stuffed. I really don't want to eat them, but I already placed this order like since earlier in the day, and I don't want to let it go to waste. So we're gonna power through it, but we'll be done eating for the night. I can't even think about eating or drinking anything else after this, but I think I'm actually thirsty for water at this point. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and try to conquer these. Hopefully they don't conquer us, but let's dig in and give it a rating. Rating.
8.
All right, I'm proud of you. I think you're gonna like it. Okay, let me tell you what I like about this. The potato part is like nice and cheesy. You can even see like the pieces of potato. But this part's really good. That cheese sauce is really nice. The shrimp's cooked really, really nice like too. They're not overcooked. They're not super like fishy either. You know, sometimes you would think like shrimp from a theme park would be like kind of gross, but it's actually not fishy at all. Really nice, still tastes fresh even towards the end of the night. These nopales are really good. Like, it has a little bit of a kick, honestly. She gives it an 8. I give it an 8 as well. I definitely think it's worth the tab. Okay, so my sister did not like the empanada. So it was really mid. But I gave it actually an 8. At first, the first bite, I was like, eh. I couldn't remember if I liked it in the past or not. But you know what? I actually really liked it. It had a nice flavor. The more you start to eat it, I just can't eat anymore. She dropped her piece. So that's done. But I'm completely tapped out. Completely tapped out. Really good though. I recommend it. I would say a solid 8. Okay, so we are going to go into Disneyland right now, but we figured it was going to be packed because everyone's on Main Street waiting for the parade or the fireworks to start, but I don't think they're doing fireworks tonight just because the wind conditions, but we're going to go into Downtown Disney. Into the Lego store.
like stuff inside. I'll show you the other side of it. Mistake coming into the home store. Look how cute this is. I don't know if you can tell, but it lights up. This is $34.99. At night. That sleepy eye is how my eyes feel right now. It's nothing like the Dumbo that we drew earlier. So everything right now is like pretty much a 5-minute wait, which is always usual for this time of night, but we're going to hop on Thunder Mountain right now. That's like our staple at night, so that's what we're gonna do. And shut it down. Okay, so we got rained on quite a bit this time.
Yes, our
more than the last time, I think.
Ice cream buddy murder, because we're getting whipped around.
We also had our eyes closed the entire time.
It was so scary as heck.
Scary as heck. So, we shut the park down, as usual. But, it's a ghost town in Frontierland.
Yeah, I just wanted to end today's video. I didn't get to do an outro inside the parks or on my way out, so I figured I would just end out today's video here in my room. But I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you guys do Food and Wine Festival this year, please let me know what you end up trying and what some of your favorite items are. Let me know in the comments and what your least favorite items were, because I know I think I had at least one that I didn't like. And I think it was probably the chicken lollipop. I think that one was like my least favorite, but let me know what you guys end up trying. This is going on from now up until, I want to say it's April 22nd. If it's not April 20th, it's April 22nd. Now that I think about it, I think it is the 22nd. So if you get a chance to do the Food and Wine Festival, I definitely recommend it. They have something new this year, so you can do a booklet of 4 tabs or your usual 8. So the tabs of 4 are, those come out to $31. And that's not like including like a magic key discount. So that comes up to $31. And if you do 8, it comes up to, I think it was like 56. So it is a little bit of a better deal if you do just the 8 tabs. But like when we come and it's like the 3 of us, usually we can do 8 tabs and we split it amongst the 3 of us and we're super full like by the end of the night. So that's the nice part. But if you have an extra person with you and you need some extra tabs, it's nice that you can just purchase another extra 4 rather than a whole another set of 8 tabs. So just a nice little option, or if you're stopping by on a whim and you just wanna have a few items, then you can do a booklet of 4. So I thought that was really nice. That was something that they haven't done in the previous years from, you know, at least to my knowledge, but
Again, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please make sure to leave me a like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.